Hey guys, JTadventures, and I wanted to do a little infield review of my kabar warthog, and this is what I've been carrying today. I just wanted to do a review out in the woods because I've never done a field, like out in the field review of a product or a knife or whatever. So let's get right into it. So I've had this knife for about, about 2 years or so, and it's been a really good knife. Some people have like a hard time flicking it open when they first, I know I did when I first got it because it's kind of tight, and then they had, like my brother, thinks it's hard to close the liner lock, but I've gotten used to it because of all the years of doing it. And you can see like the wear on the thumb stud. Focus, there you go. From opening and closing it so much. So it's pretty easy to open now that I've broken it in. And then on the blade you can see it's worn out. The coating at least. It's like a really good coating. Like I've cut multiple like soda bottles with this because I get bored and I just cut up my soda bottle, and it's only the line pretty much that's actually worn off. And then I'll annotate the steel because I don't know the steel right off the top of my head, but the knife overall is 4 ounces, which is a perfect like weight for the size of the knife, and it has steel liners, but they're not skeletonized. So steel, and it's a liner lock, as I said. And it has a G10 handle, and G10 is a really good handle material. And this knife is like way cheap, so you could use this and then like wear it out or break it, and you could just get another one. That's how cheap they are. And then it's got like jimping on the back too. Sorry about that. On the back, and then right here. So it gives you really good purchase as you're cutting stuff. And then it's like a good enough grip on here. The swell here at the bottom is really good for holding on to it. So if you like want like more leverage when you're cutting, you can hold on to the bottom of this and it gets a good grip on there. And then this is what it looks like in the hand. And I've gotten a pretty good edge on here now. It came with a decent edge, but now I've gotten a really good edge on here. It's really easy to sharpen, so I think it's a softer steel, but it loses its edge pretty fast. And it says K-bar right here. And then 3072, and it's made in China. And then the thumb studs, you can switch it over so it is ambidextrous if you want to. And then it's like the warthog design blade. So there's like the big fixed blade warthog, which is what this is based off of. And this is what the design looks like. And it has this false edge on top. And then it's a good lockup. There's a little bit of side-to-side play, but none up and down. And then the way you tighten this, you just get like a star wrench, a star key or whatever they're called, and you just tighten it. My dad has one too, and his is the serrated one. And his is a lot easier to flick open and stuff like that. and then you can hear it lock in. So there's like a little ball that it locks in to the when it's closed. So you can hear that. And here's the pocket clip. You can move it quite a bit. And I like how it has a higher up pocket clip, so you can like get thicker pants in there too. Some folding knives have really narrow openings for the pocket clip, so this is a really good clip. And so some of the specs is it has a 4.5 inch, it's 4.5 inches closed this way, 4.5 inches, and then 7.5 overall, and then a 3-inch blade. So it's a pretty decent sized folder, and it's highly recommended for how high a value knife it is. So let's go do some testing on it.
2 hours later.
Okay guys, we're back at home, and I just got two things right now in here that you'd like come across on like a daily basis maybe, and we're just gonna see how the kabar warthog does with the material. So first we just have this piece of cardboard, pretty thick stuff I'd say. So let's just see how it does. Yeah, that's pretty thick stuff. It's not gliding through like butter, but it's taking one swipe to cut. Quite a bit of force to cut this. Yeah, so here's the cardboard, and then we got some paracord right here. Let's just quick through the paracord. And then double it up. Let's triple it up. Two. So there's four. So quadrupled it. So let's see if we can do four. Yeah. There's four. So there's paracord in the warthog. So that's just a little demonstration of its cutting. Here's the cardboard. Zoom in a little. So that's my review on the kabar warthog. It's a great EDC knife, I think. And for the price, you just can't beat the quality of this, on this high of value knife. So go check out the warthog if you liked the way it performed. That's all we have for this review. Thanks for watching. Thanks to our subscribers. And if you're new here, this is the kind of stuff we like to do. So go ahead and subscribe if you want to, and like if you liked what you saw here, and thanks for watching, guys.